Time and General, Linda Mary Montano, 1990. This paper is divided into six sections. One, time and general. Two, my use of time and performance. Three, reasons for using time. Four, time in the university. Five, timelessness in Eastern thought, as explained by Dr. Ramamurti Mishra. Definition of time. In childhood, there is not time, only the feeling of space, expansion, and infinite possibility. Time is a concept that is taught, learned, and defined in Webster's dictionary. In a 6-inch column using minuscule type, it reads, quote, time is the measured or measurable period during which an action, process, or condition exists or continues, end quote. Another says, quote, time is a continuum which lacks spatial dimension and in which events succeed one another from past to present to the future, end quote. Once I lost the feeling of space in childhood, I began romancing time because my life became a series of thoughts about events instead of mythological journeys, the mental food of the child. As a good Catholic girl, I monitored my mental, physical, and emotional responses to life so that I could avoid sinning by thought, word, or deed. In the process, I began to appropriate and play with time and controlled it with the same intensity that I controlled my actions. I counted, watched clocks, competed with time by giving myself temporal deadlines. I would clock off minutes and seconds and make rules. For example, I would say that I would move or not move by the count of two. In retrospect, I realized that I was enjoying a control and power that allowed for a deep mental and poetic intimacy and spaciousness. Time became my playmate and my friend. It was a doll and obedient servant. Time and my work. When I talk about time in my art, I am not referring to physics and the concepts the scientists think about, like time and entropy, time and random fluctuations, time and measurableness, time and relativity, time and black holes, time and motion, time and force, time and a block universe, time and the Big Bang, time and entropy. No, this is not my language. Conversely, as an artist, I believe that all is available to me. And since the 60s, I invited time and its purity, time and its invisibility, time and its malleability, time and its mysteriousness to play with me. I'm not going to change the course and emotionally blame my fascination with time on the fact that my dad didn't have any, because as a child of the Depression and World War II climate of dread, he worked 24/7, 6.5 days a week to feed, clothe, and house all six of us. Time took Dad from me. So I took time away from time and made art about time. Strange thinking, but maybe there is some truth in this. Let me now share with you a few slides of some of my durations, endurances, so that we can see how time and I learn to finally dance together for these last 60 years. Time and chickens, one. For my MFA, I showed 9 live chickens at the University of Madison in 3 giant minimalist-looking cages. Two, time and marking time, walking on a treadmill for 3 hours, telling the story of my life, wearing a permanent smile device. Three, Time and meditation, lying dead, chicken live angel. I laid in an angel chicken bed for 3 hours as a saint and statue. Poor time and availability, sitting in my garage for 8 hours, garage talk, being available like my grandmother was. 5, time and exposure, talking about sex while under hypnosis, dressed like my sister. I hid under hypnosis time and not clock time. 6, time and trance, dancing for 3 hours to produce trance in the sign of a cross. 7, time and life, living art, living in a gallery for 3 days as art life. 8, time and persona morphing, living in a gallery for 5 days as 5 different people. 1 drawing a day is that persona. 9, time and pain, living for 3 hours in a gallery with acupuncture needles in my heart. 10, time and missing love, sending my astral self to another city. 11, time and living as art, living in a van as art for many days. 12, time and living sculpture, living in a gallery as life. 13, time and no sight, living without sight for a week, performed many different times. 14, time and travel, organizing a walking club and inviting others to walk with me. In the 70s, I transformed time into matter. I molded it, sculpted it, painted with it, designed with it. It was how I always structured my art. Three reasons for using time in my art. By durating in art for extended periods of time, I found that among other things, I was able to affect my physical chemistry. Basically, my art was a cheap drug and time was the pill. Athletes use running, I use duration. And it's been found that long-term activity releases histamines and adrenaline into the bloodstream, and that leads to a cessation of pain. Joseph Preville, in the book Human Physiology, theorizes that endorphins, enkephalins, and dynorphins bind to opiate receptors in the brain and body, triggering a series of physiologic events that induce narcotic effects like drowsiness, hallucinations, and the inhibition of stress or distress. I use art to change my mood and do all of the above. 15, time and stopping time, handcuffed to Tom Marioni 3 days, experiencing time together. 16, time and availability, garage talk, spending 8 hours working as an artist in my garage. 17, time and purification, telling my sins from the San Francisco balcony for 7 hours. 18, time and attachment, dressing as a nurse to obliterate my attachment to my own self as an artist. 19, time and death, telling the story of Mitchell Payne's death, leaving time. 20, time and freedom, spending 1 year tied with an 8-foot rope to Tayshan Shea in his Art Life 1 year performance. 21, time and giving my time, offering Art Life counseling as a way to make time, to be intimate with others. 22, time and obliteration of gender, becoming a male and female in balance. 23, time and the 7 chakras and glands, spending 14 years to become acquainted with the chakras and glands. 25, time and repeating time, repeating 7 years of living art, of chakra experience. 25, time and writing about time, asking others to support my work via another book. 26, time and taking time to teach. Teaching others takes time and gives time. 27, time and the end of time, dead art, taking care of dead as art. 28, time and silence, lying down in front of the Black Madonna and letting go of time. 5, timelessness. I will not stop dreaming if the dream is too big for the university. 4, time in the university before I took a full-time tenure track university teaching position at the University of Texas Austin 3.5 years ago. My work was devoted full-time to large-scale projects. I made my living by teaching part-time and working part-time at blue-collar jobs. When I came to the university in 1991, I had already completed many endurances, and I was in the second 7 years of 14 years of living art. I took this job knowing that I could do two things at once. That is, I could continue to perform another 7 years of living art and keep the three-part commitment that the university asks of its professors. One, a commitment to private research performance in books. Two, a commitment to teaching office hours and seeing students doing independent studies. Three, a commitment to five administrative committees. The world is my studio and my life is art. So logistically, teaching is my art, as was suggested by Joseph Beuys, whose theory of social sculpture expanded the concept of art and time. His classes at the Dusseldorf Academy were sculpturally forming artists for life on every level. He says, quote, "Artists must be needed from top to bottom. We are malleable and might turn out to be an agriculturist, doctors, computer scientists, police officers, mothers, but always the artists." End quote. Five, timelessness. I will not stop dreaming. If the dream is too big for the university job, I will have to leave, even though I love and am addicted to the security, the money, the health insurance, the dental plan, and my students. Never a team player. I might have to leave, having been on my own since 1970. And never learning how or wanting to spend, quote, time, end quote, with the other members of the team. I do life my way. The muse is timeless and more powerful than money. And if I hear her call for me to recalibrate and follow the path of space and leave the university, I will do so. And then design a new way to consciously prepare for my last performance, the performance of the death of the body and mind. Without time, there is only space. Soon, I will be only space and not time.